So it is the 100th anniversary of the building that we're broadcasting from right now here at the corner of State and Lake in Chicago's Loop.
Our own Janet Davies takes a look at the remarkable history of this place over a century and how many changes it's really seen.
The corner of State and Lake has quite a history. Turning back the clock, in 1830, the first town plat called this Block 36. 3 years later, Chicago's first Catholic church, St. Mary's, was built here. Still a parish on South Michigan Avenue.
Our parish still includes the site of its original location. Our parish boundaries go that far. So that includes all of the Loop.
1836, the church moved, replacing it a wooden hotel, the European, destroyed by the Great Fire. Chicago rebuilt and a commercial building sat on the site. Eventually, Balaban and Katz Theater Corporation, movie palace builders, bought the property for their headquarters, hiring two architect brothers, C.W. and George Rapp. Rapp and Rapp later would build the B&K palaces, like the Chicago across the street. Charles Ward Rapp's book on the duo explains our building is constructed two ways because of World War I.
So all the steel dried up. You couldn't get materials to build. So that put everything on hold. But then they employed for the top stories in the state like reinforced concrete, concrete blocks with rebar to support them. And that was a new deal. It was very unusual to be used for something like that.
1918, 190 North State opened. 1 year after, a 2,800-seat vaudeville house, the State Lake, debuted. Constructed and owned by the Orpheum Circuit, but accessed through our building. It morphed into a movie house later bought by Balaban and Katz. In 1995, I took the retired Elmer Balaban on a tour with his famous son, Bob.
This is the building where my dad had his office for 45 years. And when I was 4 years old, I used to have my hair cut on a pony downstairs in a barbershop.
And this building behind me became home to many of Chicago's leading furriers. But in 1939, Balaban and Katz created experimental W9XBK. Chicago Now had its very first television station. Janet Davies, ABC 7 Eyewitness News.